The PBA Tour opens the 2016 season today. The greatest bowlers in the world picked a partner and will compete as doubles teams in pursuit of PBA Tour titles. In the 2016 Mark Roth Marshall Holman PBA Doubles Championship from Reno, in the company of Roth and Holman, the greatest doubles team in history. Welcome inside the Kingpin Club at the National Bowling Stadium in Reno, Nevada. Coming up, doubles teams look to ascend the stepladder to the title match. In fifth position, Jason Belmonte with Bill O'Neill. Qualifying in fourth, Matt McNiel and Anthony Pepe, the left-handers. In third, Josh Blanchard with Andres Gomez. In second, Don Barrett and Osku Palermaa. The tournament leaders are Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen. And hello again, everyone. Mike Jakubowski with PBA Hall of Famer, 13-time titleist Randy Peterson, and Kimberly Pressler is reporting laneside today. Randy, it's a very interesting mix of teams going up the ladder today, but even more interesting, the tournament leaders.
Yeah, and this tournament really features some of the biggest names the tour has to offer. Reigning Player of the Year Jason Belmonte will team with former U.S. Open champ Bill O'Neill. The world champions, Dominic Barrett and Osku Palermaa, make another powerhouse team. But your tournament leaders is a team comprised of an 18-year-old in Anthony Simonsen making his first ever telecast, and Connor Pickford, 23 years of age, making only his second show. Can the youngsters handle the intense pressure under the bright lights in a championship match on the biggest stage the PBA Tour has to offer?
We'll find out which one of those four teams ascends to our stepladder title match. Kimberly Pressler is with one of those four teams. Kimberly.
Thanks, Mike. I am joined by Bill O'Neill and Jason Belmonte. Now, you guys are really good friends off the lanes, but how much does it mean to you guys to be able to compete in something like this?
For me, it's great. I'm bowling with the best bowler in the world, so how could I feel bad about it?
Jason, you agree with that?
I'm glad he thinks that about me. But generally, you know, I watch Billy bowl and I'm always like, man, I wish I could just bowl with that guy. So when, you know, the doubles turns around or there's a team event, you know, I love bowling with this guy. I trust him. I know he's going to throw good shots and hopefully we can put it together, mate. What do you reckon?
All right. Well, good luck to you guys today. They've got great chemistry. Let's see if it'll help them climb the stepladder.
And we're using the Mark Roth oil pattern, 46 feet in length. Very slick, high volume, a lot of oil. We watched the players in warm-up using a lot of surface and some extremely strong, powerful bowling balls. And speaking of power, back in their day, those two gentlemen right there, Mark Roth and Marshall Holman, well, that was power personified back late 70s, early 80s.
Mark Roth, father of the modern power game, and now Bill O'Neill, 7 career PBA titles, looking for his 8th today in this title event. Opening shot. A little tight on the nose, and it's a 3-6-10.
Now this is the full yank right at the bottom of the swing for Bill O'Neill. Now, if that pattern was about 51 or 2 feet in length, that would have held pocket.
O'Neill out of Langhorne, Pennsylvania, 34 years old, prime of his career. Good spare, slashing the box for O'Neill and Belmonte.
O'Neill started the match for his team, which means Belmonte will finish the 10th frame.
Players alternate frames. And now our first look at Matt McNiel, 30 years old, out of Prior Lake, Minnesota. A United States Bowling Congress multi-eagle titleist. Just picked up his PBA card bowling professionally. Power mix from the lefty.
Matt McNiel is the real deal. This guy's got a lot of experience, as you mentioned, Mike. He knows how to handle pressure, even though this is his first televised appearance on the PBA Tour. But that kid's got a lot of moxie.
Anthony Pepe, a a winner at the PBA Cheetah Championship in 2014, teaming with McNiel. Handed a strike, trying to double up for his partner, second frame, opening match. Push. A little high, and 2-4.
All right.
A little soft. How do you like that shirt?
It's all right, brother. Come on.
Is that Bowser?
It's a puppy. I can't take my eyes off the back of his shirt. I'm sorry. A little soft with the speed here. The ball overhooks, goes for the nose, but no split, just the 2-4 standing.
Creative design on the player ensemble. Classic form of Pepe and an open frame. Tough start for Anthony Pepe. And a little tougher when you have a partner.
Yeah, it's just you, you can go back and just kick yourself, but you have a partner relying on you, it makes it that much saltier.
12-time titleist, future Hall of Famer Jason Belmonte is up for O'Neill, and Belmonte working on the O'Neill spare. That's going to skate wide, and it is a 210.
Gets the opening, and if he doesn't convert the 210 split, he's going to give it right back to McNiel and Pepe. Looked like a pretty good shot, but the ball hydroplanes.
Man, way wide, 8 out.
Right now, the only strike thrown in 4 shots is from the newcomer, Matt McNiel.
Bill O'Neill gets up in the third frame. Two titles in the 2015 campaign. And Swisher.
You can see just how subtle the ball reaction is in the back part of the lane. That's why the players are going so straight.
Strike on the board, hands it off for the potential Belmonte double. Here's another look.
Hit him thin and watch him spin. It's exactly what O'Neill does right here. That's why you put revolutions on a bowling ball, Mike J.
Revolutions equal success when applied in the proper manner. Here is Matt McNiel.
Oh, get lucky. That's not very lucky. Come on, brother. Yeah. Plenty nervous out there.
Matt doing his own commentary for us.
Well, he just told you how his emotions are. And
if a player leaves and converts the 7-10 split on today's show, he will earn the $100,000 ultimate spare bonus courtesy of Ultimate Bowling.
See what kind of adjustment Anthony makes on this next shot. Last shot went through the nose.
And the pesky head pin.
All right, can't chat that one.
It's not the most common leave. I'll tell you what, nothing feels worse than missing the head pin twice, and he doesn't want to be a victim of that.
Almost backdoored it, but just the one remains. The one in front.
Early on, players making this Mark Roth oil pattern look pretty tough.
Slash in the box, teams feeling each other out. Roth Holman PBA doubles championship.
Belmo, with all those revolutions, if he squares up too much to the 1-3, the ball definitely go through the nose. I think it's a speed adjustment for him.
O'Neill handed him a strike, fourth frame. And team double, splash power mix for Belmonte.
Talk about pin action. The power of the two-handers. That's a lot of pin action.
Team play
O'Neill got it started. Belmonte doubles, hands it right back to O'Neill, looking for the turkey. They lead by 19 pins. The winner here will face the number three seed, Josh Blanchard, with Andres Gomez in our next match. Tug just a bit inside of target line, 3-6-10.
He knew it immediately as soon as it left his hand. As all the great players do, it's a field sport as well. He knew exactly what happened. Again, when the player doesn't feel like he has an inch to the right, the tendency is to miss left. And that's exactly what happened. The good news, no split, just the 3-6-10 standing for Bill O'Neill.
Good conversion, slash in the box, spare for O'Neill. They maintain a 16-pin lead, Belmonte O'Neill.
Want to swap lanes? Back home.
Belmonte asking if O'Neill would like to swap lanes. They could do that if they advance.
Yeah, that's a great point. If the players don't like the look that they have, if they do advance, they can flip-flop.
That's better. Well, got off my hand better.
Pepe and McNiel, the only all-Southpaw team on the telecast today. Really smooth into the foul line. This kid has got a lot of game, but a little different game when you're bowling on television on the PBA Tour for the very, very first time.
And Roth and Holman are looking on. Cleans up the box, just a 17-pin disadvantage. Anthony Pepe looking to get things started for McNiel Pepe. Sixth frame of our opening match, PBA Doubles Championship. For PBA titles, field was 50 teams qualifying in match play, taking place at the Fall Classic at South Point Bowling Center, and the finalists advancing here to the Kingpin Club.
Give him a chance. Yeah. All right, all right.
Wide and just a 9-pin.
Well, the ball looked like it was online, but just never got up to the pocket. Anthony Pepe went high, then he went light, light again.
All right, sir.
Belmonte and O'Neill are up 18 pins, looking to move up the stepladder. And the opening of the 2016 PBA Tour is off to a start here at the Roth-Holman PBA Doubles Championship. The Mark Roth Marshall Holman PBA Doubles Championship, presented by Storm, is brought to you by Storm, where innovation and passion collide. Storm is the bowler's company. By Reno Tahoe USA, for your next vacation getaway, go to visitrenotahoe.com. By Barbasol Shaving Cream, America's leader for a close, comfortable shave, now with new rust-proof aluminum bottoms. And by the USBC, a future for the sport. The National Bowling Stadium in Reno, Nevada, highlighted by the 80-foot aluminum geodesic dome built to resemble a large bowling ball. Time now for the Extra Frame Tournament Highlights. 16 games of qualifying in two rounds of six-game match play determined our finalists in action competed at South Point Bowling Plaza in Las Vegas. Top three seeds set early. Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen charging their way to the top will bowl for the title. Osku Palermaa with Dom Barrett number two. Josh Blanchard and Andres Gomez number three, fourth through seventh, separated by just 30 pins. DJ Archer with Sean Maldonado were fourth heading into position round. And a tough finish and an open frame dropped Archer and Maldonado out of the top five. Anthony Pepe with Matt McNiel sat in sixth place before the position round. McNiel propelled the team from sixth to fourth by rolling a clutch 277 game. EJ Tackett and Rhino Page were the number five seeds, but a loss in the position round match would drop that team out of the show. Jason Belmonte and Bill O'Neill came from seventh position, with a strong finish to win their position round match and make today's final Roth-Holman doubles field.
Kingpin Club in Reno and the Roth-Holman PBA doubles opening event of the 2016 PBA Tour finds Jason Belmonte and Bill O'Neill up 18 pins in our opening match. And the team of Belmonte and O'Neill, team on the lanes and maybe the 21st century version of bosom buddies.
I've been saying it all week, the reason why we're partners, everybody else hates him. I'm the only one left.
The truth comes out.
So if he doesn't bowl with me, he doesn't bowl with anyone. And the way I look at it is, he's best bowler in the world, I might as well use that to my advantage.
So I kind of kiss his butt all year for these moments
that I can hop on his back and let him ride me to
TV shows. I think they would bowl
shows.
With me. I just don't think they would give me a high five. You know, I think they would go, yeah, I'll bowl with you because you're probably going to do well, but they don't. You know, he at least gives me a little fist bump every now and then, you know, a little high five.
When you roll the two pin, they would be angry. Yeah.
Well,
they'd
if I don't strike,
angry at the
I
same
heard
time.
Him actually say a few times when I don't strike, I heard him say, you know, things that we can't say now in favor of me, like, you know, and that does never happens from anyone else.
Well, they're great friends off the lanes, and they put together a pretty powerful team. Really good chemistry for those two guys right there. Tour roommates and good buddies. As we take a look at Jason's arsenal using an eternal cell, I wonder if Big Earn and Roy Munson would have made a good doubles team.
It's light, but he rolls the two out. And
you remember what Bill said in the interview?
Yeah.
So, or I'm sorry, it was Jason who said something about rolling the two pin, and sure enough, wow, talk about foreshadowing. Is that the word, Mike?
It is, and here's
the roll two pin right there, trip two.
Ask for it, and it shall come. Those two competitors and your kidding around game better be up to snuff out here on the tour as well.
Belmonte's not only a good bowler, he's clairvoyant. I had no idea.
Hurry. No, seven pin. Chance to extend the lead, falls short.
Really good shot here by Bill O'Neill and needs it to get up to the pocket just a little bit. Bill O'Neill in the gym, really good athlete, great form. Bad result on a really good shot. He's got a really dry sense of humor. He said he gets it from his father. Very entertaining guy.
Been paying for your good fortune for so long.
Don't do that. Just do what I did. Jeez. Stop trying to bowl good.
That's so great. Belmonte tells Bill O'Neill, stop trying to bowl good. Just do what I did. Matt McNiel using Nirvana.
It's the strongest ball in his bag. The 10 represents the maximum hook potential.
And it is a ball change, MJ.
Peel.
Didn't quite get there. Six pin.
All right. Yeah, man. Burn up that spot, and now you roll it into it, and it goes high, and you try to get around it, and it goes straight. Not a good practice strategy.
Well, I just told you his dilemma.
One time right here. Come on.
And a correction on Matt McNeil's ball change. It was a mastermind brainiac.
Pepe backs off for just a moment. McNeil, Pepe trail by 19. It's getting late in our opening match. Eighth frame.
Look out.
Stay out.
Pretty fine strip
right,
out there.
Start.
A little bit
Come
to
on.
The left, and it hits
it
a sheet of ice, and he gets it a little bit to the inside, and it goes through the nose. Question is, can he move a big step to the right and completely change his line? Maybe get a little closer to second arrow, because that part of the lane looks unplayable.
Oh,
of them. All right.
Spare conversion and count drops.
You can do this. Remember that guy who shot 290 on TV? Be that guy. Let me see that guy one time. One time.
Pepe may have that opportunity in the 10th if Belmonte and O'Neill don't step on the gas. Eighth frame spare working.
Look out.
Two and five.
Even with all those revolutions and power, he can't get his ball to turn up to the pocket. That looked pretty firm in terms of ball speed. See how straight he's going through the front part of the lane, and that ball is just skating down the lane.
Ball hits both pins. Spare for Belmonte and O'Neill. They lead by 21, two frames left. Last shot for Bill O'Neill will come in the foundation frame as he hopes to set up Belmonte in the 10th. Bowler's best friend, the trip four.
If you're right-handed. Sets up the 10th frame. They're in good shape. Spare strike, they'll shoot 191. McNiel and Pepe, if they strike out, the best they can shoot 190. Only one strike for the Southpaws in this opening match.
Last chance for McNiel. That's a nose, and it's the big four.
Hold it over my toe. Folks, I promise I'm a lot better than this.
This is the end of the, or any chance the Southpaws had today. One strike for McNiel and Pepe. Never figured out this oil pattern, never got lined up to the pocket. Never got comfortable.
Hey.
Make it two.
Too little, too late. Pepe had 11 of those in his television debut on round to 295, on round to defeating Dick Allen in the 2014 Cheetah. Top five finish here at the Roth Holman PBA Doubles Championship, finishing up.
Whoa. All right, well, at least we tied at a strike apiece.
Tough to watch when the players can't hit the pocket. And I know it's tough on them.
All right, man.
All right, let's see what Belmonte does in the 10th frame.
I love you, man. We'll get him next time.
That'll be interesting to see if they swap lanes.
That can also, we'll get down.
You're going to try to move one and the gear down?
No, I was going to see what happens.
Okay.
Softer speed there, Mike, and it turned the corner.
Like that?
It's okay. Yeah.
Jason Belmonte with Bill O'Neill. Move up the stepladder, defeating Anthony Pepe and Matt McNiel, and now move on to face Josh Blanchard with Andres Gomez next at the Roth Holman Doubles. The Roth Holman PBA Doubles Championship presented by Storm rolls out at the Kingpin Club at the National Bowling Stadium in Reno. Jason Belmonte with Bill O'Neill advance with a 196 game and will bowl in our second match against Josh Blanchard and Andres Gomez on the way to the semifinal and today's title match.
Will Jason Belmonte's back-to-back major wins in 2015 propel him to a third straight Player of the Year award? PBA Tour Commissioner Tom Clark will make that announcement at 4 p.m. Eastern on January 20th. How does Jason Belmonte do what he does, and who is behind it?
So the way that I bowl is a little different. It's with two hands. It all started when I was really, really little. I was 18 months old when I first rolled my first ball. And the lightest bowling ball we had back then was 10 pounds. So I just couldn't pick it up with one hand. And as I was getting older and still not strong enough to use a traditional one hand, I developed a two-handed technique. And once I saw that ball curve from the left side to the right side, back to the left side, that was the end of me. You know, I just loved to see that ball curve. I met Kimberly when we were really young. I was a smart-assed, cheeky, some would probably say arrogant person. I think for the first couple of years she let a few things slide, you know, we're just kids, and then one day she kind of just, you know, pulled in the reins and said, listen, what's going on? Like, who are you? Let's work this out. And she really helps me kind of walk the path that I want to walk and that I think that I'm supposed to walk. You know, she's pretty much everything to me and my family. I mean, I'm away for 6 months a year. I had two beautiful children and one on the way, and she, you know, keeps the ship afloat back home. And not only does she do that, she somehow still keeps me afloat when I'm over here through our conversation. So she's pretty remarkable. If push came to shove between my career and my family, I mean, it's literally a no-brainer for me. I mean, I would take the shoes off and never roll a ball again. As much as I love this sport, you know, I love my family a billion times more.
The two-handed style of Jason Belmonte reinventing the power game of professional bowling. Roth Holman doubles, featuring two of the greatest power players in history. This Columbia 300 fun fact, Mark Roth and Marshall Holman combined to make the TV finals in PBA doubles events five times, winning three doubles titles.
Yeah, back then, how did it feel to put together a doubles team thinking, hey, second place isn't bad?
Kimberly Pressler is with one of the greatest doubles teams in history.
That's right, and it's an honor to be down here with these two legends. So Marshall, you know, you guys were great doubles partners. This is your namesake event, but what was it like actually bowling together?
Well, it was great. You know, I was an up-and-comer. He was an established star. Mark asked me to bowl in the doubles together. It took me about a millisecond to say absolutely. It gave me great confidence. Really helped me with the rest of my career. And I like watching these young guys. It's a lot of fun.
Now, Mark, you guys were just watching the video of you guys playing back in the day and smiling big. What would you say is your favorite memory of bowling with Marshall?
We had a match during qualifying or match play. I would go first, line him up. I went, missed the head pin, chopped a spare, and I left a 4-9. I had 18 in the second. I struck out, and he shot 250. So I think I did my job for the day, and it was fun bowling with him, so I would go first, line him up, so I could line up a little quicker. And we had a lot of fun, just beating up on everybody.
Marshall, do you remember that?
I do, and I agree. Mark was great. You know, we both threw the ball similar, so he could throw a shot, find out what was happening with lane, let me know. That way I didn't have to make the mistakes. So it did make my life a little easier.
Well, it is really great having you both here. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Kimberly. Our next match coming up with Josh Blanchard and Andres Gomez. How did they become friends? We'll find out about that in our next match. Extra Frame, the PBA's online video subscription service, has exclusive live coverage of every PBA, PBA 50, and PWBA event. Extra Frame's big February calendar features coverage of three consecutive majors, the Fire Lake PBA Tournament of Champions, the USBC Masters, and the Barbasol PBA Players Championship. Three-day, monthly, and yearly subscriptions are available. For more information, click on the Extra Frame link at pba.com. Kimberly Pressler is with our number three qualifiers.
Thanks, Mike. So, Josh, what is it you think that you each bring to this doubles match?
I think we each bring something different. I bring consistency and hitting the pocket quite a bit and spares, and Andres brings that X factor where he can strike at any time from any angle, and so together we have a great combination.
Now, Andres, What is it that you guys think that you feed off of each other? Like, how much do you feed off of each other?
Well, we definitely have very different games, and I think that has been part of our success out here and making this show. And, you know, we're just going to have fun and relax.
All right. Well, good luck to both of you, guys.
Randy, is contrasting styles or similar styles, does it matter in the doubles makeup?
Well, you know, I used to roll doubles with Tom Kreitz, and we could actually line up off of each other because we had similar games, and I think it's a better combination that way. When you're both playing the same part of the lane, you can read each other's ball reactions. I think that's a big advantage. That's why you don't see a lot of teams that are comprised of a lefty and a righty.
O'Neill and Belmonte advance. And Bill opens with the paradox, 9.5 out of a potential 10 on the hook scale. High flush. And a trip four from behind.
When did you learn to stop tripping the full pin? Oh, I don't know.
Just inside second arrow. Look at that trip four. Watch this action in the back. Hello.
Josh Blanchard out of Gilbert, Arizona. Oh, solid nine. Ball made a sharp move in the last 2 feet.
Yeah, it really did. It read the front part of the lane beautifully, and then more back end reaction than we've seen thus far on the telecast. His speed's a lot softer than Jason Belmonte's, and he can get his ball to read.
What's that?
Watch the ball go right
by
the ninth pin.
I like our chances. Yeah, two balls. I don't know. I'll buy him dinner.
7-10. Do I get half of that? I just realized.
Blanchard at the single pin, spare attempt, covers it easily. Hands off to Andres Gomez out of Bogota, Colombia. Three-time PBA Tour titleist, and Randy, for my money, one of the sweetest swings and follow-throughs in the game.
Real soft hand at the bottom. Watch the open hand finish at release. There it is.
Can strike from any angle. He got that angle.
Real good on heavy oil because of his soft ball speed. But he's done a lot of things with his roll the last couple of years, which has gotten him on television more often. He can roll it now. He used to be known as a guy that just kind of hooked it from gutter to gutter, but he's become more versatile the last couple of years, and it's really paid off.
All-world Jason Belmonte, 3 PBA Tour titles in 14, 2 majors in 15. Second frame working on the strike.
Oil pattern starting to break down a little bit. You can see Jason Belmonte starting to migrate towards the center part of the lane. And watch this massive messenger. There's the head pin. It goes right behind the 10 pin. In my opinion, MJ, that's the only way you beat Jason Belmonte. When he can get to the pocket, you hope for bad carry, which doesn't happen very often.
Kimberly Pressler has an interview for us. Kimberly.
Thanks, Mike. I'm here with Matt and Anthony. And so it seems that you guys both were having a hard time reading the lanes out there. What was the issue?
Well, you know, your first time on national television is always really, really difficult. I was pretty nervous out there, but, you know, my luck went away last couple minutes of practice, so I had to kind of make some guesses and didn't throw the greatest of shots, which doesn't make it easier either. But, you know, it's a good learning experience. We'll keep working hard, and, you know, we definitely expect to be back here.
Anthony, I have to ask you, I've seen a lot of jerseys over the years. This is the first time I've seen a puppy. Why the puppy on the jersey?
Well, there's actually two dogs on the jersey. The new dog is the one in front. His name is Stormy. And the old dog, his name is Sammy. He passed away a couple years ago. So I want to do a shirt in remembrance of my my dogs.
Well, that is very sweet. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Oh, that wasn't that good.
And back to the action. Bill O'Neill tripping the four pin again on the left lane. Josh Blanchard just goes light. And quite honestly, MJ, that shot that Blanchard just threw, I was surprised that he even actually got back to the head pin.
Last year on the PBA Tour, Blanchard going back-to-back once in Germany and then following up with a win in Portland, Maine. Covers the spare, and we're even. Slight advantage to Belmonte. O'Neill on the strike working, and back to Gomez. Handed the spare in the fourth frame. Andres struck last time around.
Gomez will finish the match. He'll bowl the 10th frame for his team. Nice looking shot in the second frame. As we take a look at his arsenal, he's throwing a haywire. Look out. Wow, it held pocket, it looked left. And it laid right there. Take a look one more time at Andres Gomez's release. Watch the open hand finish. There's another great player that uses this technique, and his name is Pete Weber. Hard to grab it when that hand is opening at the finish. Belmonte, right lane on this pair. And a double.
Dead flush. 10-pin lead for Belmonte O'Neill. Winners in their opening match. Ahead now by 10. Coming up next, it's the semifinal.
William.
Featuring Dom Barrett and Osku Palermaa teaming up. And now William. Belmo refers to Bill O'Neill.
He's only known as William to one guy out here, and that's Jason Belmonte. It's hilarious. But let's see what kind of adjustment Bill O'Neill makes right here.
Back-to-back trip fours. Again, tight in the pocket, and this time he rolls his 6-10 out late.
Oh, no.
En Dutrois. Good enough to earn today's Barbasol close shave of the day on the right side of the rack.
Left all the way, goes right through the face. Pin comes across, takes the 6-10 out for a three-bagger. And all Bill can do is sit back down in his seat next to his partner and talk strategy.
No one disdains off hits more than Bill O'Neill. X in the box.
Get up.
7-pin. Power splash hit. Fails to carry the 7.
And their team fails to double.
All single pins for Josh, and another here in the 5th.
All the great breaks that Bill O'Neill's gotten through 5 frames. If Belmonte carries that massive messenger in a second, their team's perfect. Andres Gomez, perfect. Striking the 2nd, striking the 4th.
Gomez, the native Colombian, now residing in Weston, Florida. Fellow Floridian Randy. Andres up. Andres is perfect. Gomez and Blanchard trail by 20 pins to Belmonte and O'Neill. When we return, Josh Blanchard and Andres Gomez are doubles team now, but their first meeting didn't necessarily lead you to believe they would become a doubles team. Find out more when we return. Coming up next Sunday at 3 Eastern on ESPN, it's the PBA Challenge featuring championship matches from across the world of professional bowling and team competition. Next Sunday on ESPN. Every relationship has a great story. How did Josh Blanchard and Andres Gomez become friends? Let's find out.
Don't go there. We met in Punta Cana, Dominican Republic. Back in 2007 or 2008, we were bowling next to each other in Punta Cana. Andres ended up winning that tournament, but we had an altercation. Actually,
that's how I met him.
That's how we met each other. We had an altercation against each other on the lanes, and just some issues. And then afterwards, we've become good friends since then.
Well, what happened was that I was leading the tournament. He was trying to make the cut, and I was rolling the shot, and he reset the lane on me. So as soon as the lane came down, I turn around and I look at him. I go like, he goes, I didn't do it.
Andres insists that's how it went down, Randy.
I'm not going to argue the fact.
Making friends soon thereafter and now forming this doubles team as we roll on. Belmonte and O'Neill are up 20, and Jason Belmonte has the hammer in hand, can extend the lead to 30 pins, six frame.
Carry.
Oh, my. Devastating. And that's how you take advantage of the great break that Bill O'Neill got in the fifth. I'll tell you what, all that power, you throw a bowling ball right there, perfectly between the one and the three pin, there's not going to be a whole lot left standing.
Handing it off to his partner to extend the lead even further.
Bill O'Neill has thrown three strikes, none of which have been perfect in the pocket. There's a big move left.
Come at on. 10. Unlucky, man. Unlucky.
That's classic.
It's just another example of the interplay between the teams.
And listen, everybody's laughing except the team they're bowling against, because that was a great line. And I mean, it's been all luck on Bill O'Neill's side, and Belmonte mocking that flat 10, not falling.
One too many?
Huh?
Moved one too many?
Looks like it.
Yeah.
Interesting, the last two shots that we watched from those two guys right there, though, and how much the lanes have changed in one game.
Blanchard has the Paradox Pearl, strongest ball in his bag. That's a 9-point rating on a scale of 10, indicating hook potential.
And looking for the first double in this match.
He rolls the two. They were talking about getting some kind of break, and there it is.
Interesting how that ball never even turned the corner, and it finally strikes. And the first double for Blanchard and Gomez. A lot of really good breaks in this match. Belmonte and Andres Gomez, really the only two that have actually made some great quality shots that have hit the flush, that have hit the pocket flush.
Only one good thing to do with a break, and that's take advantage of it. Gomez can strike and cut the lead to single pins, eighth frame.
Oh, no. Look out.
No. 6-9-10.
Phil would have struck from there.
Errant shot.
Mine's higher.
Come on.
He was perfect up until that shot, too, and just got it left off of his hand, goes through the face, leaving the 6-9-10. Hey, there's a brain in that ball.
Smart spare covers the 6, 9, and 10.
Slower, just the pinches.
Sitting, yeah.
Light roller,
no,
10 pin.
Right down, good nine.
Well, Phil frames and see what happens. Cover the spare, turn it over to O'Neill. He has one more shot to throw in this match before he hands the reins back over to Belmonte for the 10th frame. Belmonte looks like he's extremely comfortable now with the way the lanes have transitioned on that right lane. Right. O'Neill has made the big move in.
Pinch.
With each ball that goes down the lane, MJ, oil is being absorbed by these bowling balls, and this new oil that the PBA implemented, started back in the World Series of Bowling, really holds up well. A lot of strong bowling balls, a lot of rev rates going down the lane, and the oil pattern's holding up.
Foundation frame and a proper strike for Bill O'Neill. Didn't roll the two that time.
Almost did.
Move into it and it doesn't hook. You go away from it, hooks too much.
can't get his ball to hook up into the pocket. Back-to-back shots that look just identical. One tripped the two-pin, the second one didn't. And any hopes that this team had are all but done.
Come on, get them all.
Never know.
Andres can strike out. Their team can shoot 216. If Jason Belmonte were to get only nine in the 10th frame, they would shoot 216.
6 slaps to 10. Messenger for good measure. Roman's doing what he can to fill it up and put that 216 on the board. The winner here moves on to the semifinal, where Dom Barrett and Osku Palermaa are waiting. Coming up and waiting are our tournament leaders, Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen. Gomez takes the re-rack, second ball in the 10th, 216 max here.
Left again. Oh, holds pocket that time. Wow. I think he's a little surprised as well.
One more. Make him show up. Make him show up.
Striking the fill shot. Belmonte needs a mark.
One more.
And Andres indicating a second re-rack.
Doesn't get it. Blanchard used one. They only get two for the game.
Probably was two per player.
Not two per player, two per game.
Gomez fills it up, 216 for Gomez and Josh Blanchard.
Well, Gomez bowled nicely, but the one critical shot was when his team was working on a double. Gomez gets up in the eighth frame and went through the nose. Now Belmonte, any mark, they advance. Oh, look out.
2-8-10 split.
Just like that.
Come on, get the wood.
He needs two pins to tie. We'll have a roll-off. I hope he understands the scoreboard. You would think in this situation he would know exactly what he needs. He needs to make the 2-8 to tie.
Two 16 and a roll-off. Teams now must decide who participates in the roll-off and which lane.
Sorry, Mike.
Sorry. Got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a tie. By PBA rule, the tie must be broken by a one-ball sudden-death roll-off. The higher-seeded team, Blanchard and Gomez, will have choice of starting lane and order. If the players tie in that first shot, then the other team member will shoot again on the other lane, and they'll alternate back and forth between team members on different lanes until the tie is broken. Andres.
I go first here.
Andres is gonna start the tie break. And who's bowling first over here? Bill, you're gonna bowl first over here?
Yeah.
Okay, on the same, no, you're gonna stay on your same lane.
Yeah, right. Yeah. One-on-one. Yeah. One-on-one.
Good luck, gentlemen.
The power of filling it up and making the opponent work.
Yeah, we've seen it a lot of times over the years. We've seen it happen quite a bit, and that's why you want to, you know, finish strong and make the other team show up, because you really never know what's going to happen. And so it's extended play now for Gomez and Blanchard. Andre's almost perfect on this lane.
Great pitch.
And he gets them all. 10 count for Gomez Blanchard.
Great shot.
Four in a row on that lane for Andrés Gomez. And now Bill O'Neill must strike or his team is eliminated.
If O'Neill strikes, Blanchard and Belmonte would carry on the roll-off. O'Neill must strike.
No luck, no trip two this time. Belmonte and O'Neill are done.
The power of perseverance. Gomez, three strikes in the 10th to fill it up. And Josh Blanchard and Andrés Gomez advance to the semifinal. Don Barrett and Osku Palermaa are the next opponents. And the golden arm of Gomez delivers in the roll-off. More coming your way from Reno.
The Mark Roth Marshall Holman PBA Doubles Championship presented by Storm is brought to you by GEICO. Over 75 years of savings and service. By Eldorado Silver Legacy and Circus Circus, Reno's premier downtown properties. By Roltec. Try Roltec Action Bowling's daily contests and win real cash using your league scores. Make your mark. And Barbasol Shaving Cream, America's leader for a close, comfortable shave. Now with new rust-proof aluminum bottoms.
Circus performers, live entertainment, dining, and so much more available in downtown Reno.
Hey, Mike J, if our gig doesn't work out, maybe we can, you know, put something together.
I think we can. I've got a red nose handy. Be sure to stay logged on to PBA.com. for all the latest PBA news, player updates, and tournament information, including your chance to purchase tickets to the ESPN telecast of the Fire Lake PBA Tournament of Champions in Oklahoma. Head on over to PBA.com and click the tickets link for more information.
The Mark Roth Marshall Holman Doubles Championship. Blanchard and Gomez survived the roll-off, 10-9, to advance to face Osku Palermaa, the twin fin, and the dominator, Dom Barrett, both PBA champions, both PBA world champions. Let's learn more about this duo.
I guess it's every bowler's dream to win the majors, and we went back-to-back years. It was...
Yeah, it's really cool.
I don't know, what can you do?
And we're the second and third ever Europeans to have won a major. Mika, obviously, has won a few, and... we're the only three out of all of Europe to win majors in PBA Tour. That's pretty cool.
Osku Palermaa, the twin fin, Dom Barrett, the dominator, teaming up.
Yeah.
Get to know those gentlemen very well over the years in the World Series of Bowling era, creating the talent and worldwide talent, including this man, Andrés Gomez, with the big 10th fame performance and the big roll-off. And we move on. Semifinal, opening shot.
Trip four, strike.
You know, you look back at that last match, and if you take away the two trip fours and the nose diver by Bill O'Neill, that match isn't even close.
First look at the twin fin Osku Palermaa, one of the strongest strike balls in the game. Five PBA Tour titles out of Espoo, Finland, 32 years old. Three and the six.
Oh. I was watching a little bit of their practice, Osku and Dom Barrett, and they both looked like they were trying to play the extreme right side of the lane. It's going to be interesting to see how that pans out. Watch how fast this is.
Bam! Osku winds up on it, turns the wrist over, straight ball, obliterates the three and the six. Turns it over to Dom Barrett out of Colchester, England. Four-time winner on the PBA Tour, including that major, the PBA World Championship. And another mix of two completely different styles within the same team.
And he's playing out. Interesting strategy. You saw the success that Andres Gomez has had playing the middle part of the lane. Dom Barrett on that same lane deciding to play about two arrows right of him.
And that is two completely different approaches. There is the family of Josh Blanchard, Amy. And a six slaps to 10. And an early double. A little different start for Blanchard and Gomez.
Come on, double.
Amy expecting a second blessing to the Blanchard family in the not too distant future. Good start for Blanchard Gomez. Now Andres can put together an opening turkey.
Go through. Go
left.
No. Yeah, baby.
He slides the right side of the rack away. Break goes to Blanchard and Gomez this time.
Huge break. That could have been six. Well, it happened to them in the last match against O'Neill and Belmonte, and Andres Gomez does the same thing that O'Neill did on the same lane. Through the nose and carries the strike.
Nine sliding into the 10, the last two to fall in fortunate fashion. Now Palermaa. And that's in the nose and another 3-6.
Again, it's interesting strategy. Belmonte on that same lane that Osku is on, played in. Osku decides to play out. Both shots go through the face. Both shots leave the 3-6.
Spare conversion. And let's go to Kimberly Pressler.
Thanks, Mike. So disappointing loss for you too. But Jason, why did you guys both decide that Bill was going to throw that last ball?
Well, it should never have got to that. I should have thrown a much better shot. It was one of the worst shots I could have thrown. And Mrs. O'Neill, Bill's mum, if I'm not invited back to your place, I completely understand. So it should never have got to it. And mate, I'm sorry.
Bill, why don't you tell us what happened in your throw?
I knew I was going to be the one getting up there because we weren't going to switch lanes for the roll-off. So once Andres got up there, I knew I was going to go. And I never felt particularly comfortable out there at any point. And the shots I was throwing good, some of them went high. The ones that were bad still were bad. And I just never really felt that comfortable. And I knew I had to give away the pocket just a little bit. And it's still just a pinch firm.
Did you feel like you got adequate support from Jason?
Yeah, I mean, you know, he threw a lot of good shots. He threw one really bad one, you know, but he threw a lot of good shots, and you know, we got really fortunate in the beginning of that match to even be in it. So, you know, it's one of those things. You just, you know, move on to the next one.
All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks, Kimberly. Dom Barrett leaving the bucket, and then he chops the four pin for the open frame. Now Josh Blanchard up in the fourth, looking to extend their lead.
Shape up.
Can't get it going that far right, Josh.
Hasn't really found a consistent home to the pocket. Coming in light, leaving the two pin. Dom Barrett opening his last shot. And it's a big lead early on for Blanchard and Gomez. Andres Gomez making a ball change now.
Fifth frame. Blanchard Gomez lead by 34. Three, six, seven, ten. Split.
Come on.
Ball change and loft. But a lot more downlane reaction with this new bowling ball. Watch this. He lost it to try to get it to skid a little bit farther, and it looks pretty good right until it got to about 50 feet, and then it just snapped right through the face, leaving the 3-6-7-10.
Three of them. All right.
Open frame for Andres Gomez, decreasing the lead to 19. Gomez also had one previous doubles TV finals appearance, which came in 2011 in Las Vegas when he teamed with Martin Larson to finish fourth that year. Back over to Palermaa. Here's a look at what's in Osku's bag. He's got the critical 8-point hook rating out of a scale of 10. Splash rack, power hit, and a 7 falls. Adjustment made from the 2-3 sixes.
He moved in a little bit and threw it really hard. I mean, that was going down the lane with bad intentions. Osku Palermaa, just a freak of nature, what he can do with a bowling ball. And that ball was going down the lane with a full head of steam. Now, can they double up and cut the deficit to 9? Dom Barrett, last time up. Opened in the fourth.
Oh. He races the 10.
Good shot.
Barrett and Palermaa have each made one previous doubles TV finals. They teamed together to finish second last time around, losing to Norm Duke and Wes Smollett. They had won 2 in a row, failed to qualify through the qualifying portion at this year's doubles event. Spare for Barrett and Palermaa. Blanchard and Gomez are up 19 halfway home in the semifinal. Gomez continues to find a way to strike, and Blanchard right behind him. More when we return to Reno. The Roth-Holman PBA Doubles Championship rolls on at the Kingpin Club in Reno. And while we were away, Andres Gomez assuring his partner in no uncertain terms.
These guys are bowling so far, right?
Yeah, it's not affecting your line. That's why I figured you'd stick with the haywire, because they're not even touching your line. But I'm not. You have 2 frames.
I throw one more. I'll strike with it.
Okay.
I promise. Yeah, it wasn't a good shot.
I understand.
It wasn't terrible.
When you have the right ball and you don't throw good, you still get 9. When you have, if you don't have the right ball and you miss by a little and you get 6, that's the hard one.
Talking about the ball change that he made and the last shot that Andres threw on the left lane where he went through the nose, Andres says, I want one more crack at it with that ball. He's probably going to move 3 or 4 boards deeper and give it a little bit more room.
Blanchard Gomez lead by 19 pins, 6th frame, semifinal match.
Go through it, go through it.
Solid strike for Blanchard, hands it right back to Gomez.
More speed and more direct on that lane. Now, did Andres Gomez make the right choice? We're going to find out right here.
And he's going to make sure he's got 10 on spot with a re-rack. Everything must be right for Gomez, and now to double to extend the lead to 29. Light and doesn't shake out the 2.
Wow. Wow. Wrong ball choice. Goes through the nose, makes the adjustment, throws it good, and the ball never tips, never gets to the pocket. Question is, now what does he do? He's got one more shot to throw in the 9th frame. When you're Osku and Dom Barrett, you're liking what you're seeing right now, but they still haven't doubled.
All right, come on.
All right.
Osku Palermaa now up in the 7th frame.
Time to put on those striking shoes, get back in this match.
2 spares for Osku. He struck last time, now up in the 7th. Tight in the nose, 3-6-10.
It's not very often that you see Osku Palermaa playing right of Josh Blanchard, but that's exactly what's happening. He's trying to to go out the pocket with a lot of speed.
Gomez with the storm break trust, and Palermaa cleans up with 3-6-10. On count, Blanchard Gomez now lead by 22. Important shot here for Dom Barrett, Randy.
Yeah, it really is. Take a look at Dom Barrett's arsenal. Also using a critical. Last time up on this lane, he made a really good shot and left a pocket 7-pin. He needs to strike here to set something up for his team.
Getting late in the semifinal match, the non-titleists, Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen, are waiting in the title match.
Wow,
9-pin.
It's terrible.
You heard him say it's terrible. It looked like it was left the whole way and probably fortunate to hit the pocket, but quite honestly, not a great break here. Solid 9.
Conversion for Barrett, but time running out.
I'm just wondering what Dom and Osku saw in practice prior to the start of this match that made them decide to play right. You know, you had Belmonte for 2 games beating up a pretty nice track right around that second arrow and chasing it in. Same thing with O'Neill playing, O'Neill and Gomez playing in on that left lane.
Tip up.
And now Blanchard and Gomez can take control. A-frame strike for Josh, handing it off to Gomez for the foundation.
Just hard for me to wrap my hands around Osku playing right of Josh Blanchard because of all the power that Osku has.
Why?
I just don't see that.
Something Kimberly may be asking, but first, Blanchard Gomez.
Back to the bowling ball I started with.
You're right, amigo. Get in! Great, great disrespect.
You were actually convincing me that this was the right ball.
You said, don't worry. Okay.
Andres Gomez reassuring his partner Josh Blanchard about the correct choice of ball. Osku Palermaa now up in the foundation frame. Max score for Barrett and Palermaa is 201. Six slaps to 10.
Come on, man.
Really good shot there, but that's a good 5 or 6 boards right of Blanchard on that lane. Dom Barrett is playing a very similar line, that 6-7 board. Andres Gomez is into almost 4th arrow on that lane.
10th frame, best Barrett Palermaa could do is 201. Gomez Blanchard pacing 2 teams. And again, fill it up. It's the only option for Dom Barrett.
Well, it happened in our last match with Belmonte and Bill O'Neill, where Andres Gomez got up and struck out and forced Jason Belmonte to mark. He did not. It went to a roll-off. And that's why Gomez and Blanchard are still bowling now. Re-rack for Dom Barrett. Looking for another strike to force Josh Blanchard to mark in the 10th frame.
Get there. Come on, Dominic.
Bucket and 187 isn't going to cut it.
Well, he was looking to strike out to put a little bit of pressure on Josh Blanchard, but just not to be. And again, you know, it's just questionable the way they played this championship pair based on what we've seen throughout the day.
Now Blanchard with room to experiment and operate in the 10th frame. They will advance to the title match. 6 slaps to 10.
Josh Blanchard, Andres Gomez make good on the promise and will face the tournament leaders coming your way next. Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen looking for their first PBA Tour titles. Take on Blanchard and Gomez. Welcome back to the Kingpin Club at the National Bowling Stadium in Reno as the PBA Roth Holman doubles roll on. And time now for the Geico Championship recap.
Hey, on match number one, it was Jason Belmonte and Bill O'Neill taking out Anthony Pepe and Matt McNiel. Belmonte with a great strike. O'Neill follows it up with a trip four for a double. They win 196-153. Then in match number two, Jason Belmonte just needed a mark in the 10th frame. He does not get it. This match goes to a roll-off. First, it's Andres. He steps up, and it's 10 in the pit. Bill O'Neill must match it. He does not. Blanchard and Gomez survive. Then in our last match, Josh Blanchard, right lane.
Go through it.
It does go through it. It goes through the pins perfectly. So does Andres Gomez. They combine for a four-bagger late. They win 233-186. That is your Geico Championship recap.
Thank you, Randy. Coming up next, it's the title match in the Roth Holman doubles. Pickford Simonsen, can they win their first tour titles against Blanchard and Gomez? Find out uninterrupted next. PBA Roth Holman doubles championship, and there they are, Roth and Holman and Randy. Everyone tried to throw it like them and still do.
Boy, when I was a little kid, I used to have this small rubber ball, and I would emulate bowling like Marshall Holman.
Heels all the way on the back of the approach. Time now to flashback with Ebonite. Another Hall of Fame doubles team, Mike Albee and Steve Cook.
Yeah, and a perfect combination of a stroker right there in Mike Albee. And big Steve Cook, the cranker. Big man with the big ball. That's nasty. Ernie Schlegel looking on with his partner, Hugh Miller. Huey goes just a little bit high, loses 6-8. And the brothers-in-law come away with one of three doubles victories to their credit.
Title match, and Kimberly is with our tournament leaders.
That's right, Mike, I am. Guys, your competitors just took out four major champions to get to you guys in the finals. How intimidating is that?
I wouldn't say it's intimidating at all, considering we're standing on top of the stepladder. But, you know, we had a great week, and they're going to be a tough competition for sure.
Are you guys nervous at all? Are you going to win?
It's just bowling. It's the same thing as always. Just try to knock down as many white guys as you can.
All right. Well, good luck to you. Then if these guys, they go into this match anything like they were doing in practice, they're going to be hard to beat because they had nothing but strikes.
All right. Let's take a look at the oil pattern. After three matches, it's really starting to go away right around that second arrow. You can see it's starting to really thin out in this area here. Players just keep chasing that blue oil towards the center part of the lane. 46 feet in length. It's not like once they start drying out, though, MJ, that you can just move in and start chucking it to the right. That won't work. But I want to see where these two young men, Anthony Simonsen and Connor Pickford, decide to play this oil pattern.
Kimberly Pressler saw a lot of strikes in the warm-up, and now the bravado in the interview, can it translate to the opening shot of Anthony Simonsen, 18 years old?
How about yes? Playing in, two-handed specialist, no thumb. First shot on national television, age 18, and it's perfect.
Blanchard and Gomez have climbed the ladder to the title match. And now Josh with the opening shot. And light, two pin.
Right. Hit up on it.
He decided to go a little bit straighter the last match on that lane, and it worked fairly well. And that time it was just two straight, and another two pin for Josh Blanchard on the right lane.
Spare for Blanchard Gomez tag team now over to Andres. Primetime performer to force the roll off. Part of the climb along the stepladder. 7 of 8 strikes in that match. Now third match of the day. Perfect shot for Andres. Found the rhythm.
Well, he stayed with that same ball. He just moved in a little bit more. Will it hold up long enough for him to get into the 10th frame and throw strikes if he needs to for his team?
And now Connor Pickford, finalist at the World Series of Bowling last year, strongly indicated that he wanted to end the match on the right lane. He's got the lane he wants. Smashes the rack. Impressive opening double.
They're just too young to know they're supposed to be nervous.
Time for this track tech talk.
Well, Jason Belmonte has really spawned this two-handed phenomenon in our sport, and you can see exactly what he does there. Now, here's young Anthony Simonsen. Pretty similar. Head's a lot lower, though. He doesn't quite have the same amount of revolutions as Jason Belmonte, but the technique is very similar. And very similar results.
Opening turkey. If Simonsen were to win today, he'd match Norm Duke with being 18, but just a few days older to be the youngest ever to win a PBA Tour title.
Yeah, I just think that happened about...
Well, back in 1983.
Do the math.
32
years ago. And I was told there would be no math.
Plenty of math in bowling. At 10. And cut the lead to 10. Good pitch, good double.
That ball.
Blanchard Gomez.
Sorry, Mike, that ball picked up and read the front part of the lane the right way and faced up. With a two-hander on the same lane as Andres Gomez, how much of is that lane going to transition? Is it going to affect Andres? How is this going to play out for the rest of the match?
Gomez up, can even things up with a strike here. Title match.
Go.
That was an arrow left. That was a big pull, and he's left himself with an extremely difficult spare attempt, the 3-6-9-10. And it's because of that back pin, the 9 pin. Here it is once again, going through the nose. He's going to try to get his bowling ball to hook into the 3 so that he can cover that back pin.
No, 3 out of 4. Tough spare to make, and extra look at that with your hammer cuff spare replay.
Moved in and got it too wide, and the ball just didn't have enough to get back into that 3-pin. Not enough friction to the right part of that lane. And it's a big opening for Pickford and Simonsen. I really like this game. Watch this, folks. Watch him snap that wrist at the bottom of the swing.
Be good. Be good.
Yes. 6 slaps of 10, opening four-bagger, taking advantage. 36-pin lead early in the title match. Kimberly Pressler has this update. Kimberly.
Thanks, Mike. So, Dom, Osku, why did you guys decide that you were going to play so far to the right?
Well, to be honest, we had to make a decision. It was either far right or far left. While practice, we didn't feel that comfortable going deep in. And then Belmonte on the lanes, well, he kind of don't want to be there when he's missing the lanes, so. Should have bowled better.
Thank you so much for your time.
Front 4. And first non-strike for Simonsen Pickford, but no back pin there. Just a 3-6-10.
much easier without the nine pin and avoids the big split. But they do have the lead. They started with the front four. You want to maintain that lead. The last thing you want to do is give your opponents an opening.
Good spare for Simonsen out of Princeton, Texas. He's got two PBA regional titles, looking to add his first national title here today. Blanchard and Gomez trail by 33 pins. Josh up after the open frame. He struck back here in the third.
There it is.
Man, it's good pitch. Damn. Too. Good pitch.
Good pitch.
That's that weak 10 zone where the ball is just not far enough left to be dead flush and not far enough right to be a wall shot. Gets into that half 10 zone. You see that a lot on the longer patterns.
All right. Why is that?
When the players decide to go straight like that, Mike J, there's just not enough drive in the back part of the lane to get the ball to finish hard enough to carry that. But when you watch the two-handers, when you watch Connor Pickford, a lot higher rev rate, more hand, and they can get the ball to finish a little bit harder in the back part of the lane.
Halfway through our title match, Pickford Simonsen with a big start. Blanchard Gomez need a big finish. Sixth frame.
He's in trouble. He's either got to open up his angles or he's got to change balls. Because right now that ball's digging in and it's going through the nose. I think his line through the front part of the lane is just too tight. You see, that ball never gets enough room to the right, and there's not enough build up in the middle part of the lane to get that thing to push farther to the right. He's got to open up his angles.
Spare conversion. Spares won't cut it.
Not when you're trailing by 36, it won't.
Come on.
Connor Pickford, the 11-12 PBA South Region Rookie of the Year, cutting his teeth down there in one of the toughest regions of the PBA.
2014 Viper Championship, he led, eventually losing to Mika Koivuniemi in the title match by 10. This kid's got some serious maple moxie. Watch this. Oh!
All right, right over.
That's a really good shot, Mike. Another flat 10 on that right lane, one by Josh Blanchard going straight, one by Connor Pickford hooking it. The revolutions of that bowling ball going down the lane.
Spare for Pickford and Simonsen. Tournament stats provided by Roltec. The qualifying averages for the doubles TV finalists, among them the high average belonged to Simonsen, 242 plus, and the low average belonged to Bill O'Neill, 223 and a half. Seventh frame, 35 pin lead for Pickford and Simonsen. They're each looking for their first PBA Tour titles. Something changed, Randy.
All right, come on,
they started down. Hot, and now we're starting to see Pickford and Simonsen having issues.
Well, not so much Pickford. He's still hitting the pocket. Simonson's lost pocket. He's gone high the last two shots in a row. And you can see his ball really picking up in the middle part of the lane. He's going to have to make a big mother may I move towards the center. He's got to move left. He's got to open up the lane. But right now what he's looking to do is not give back any pins to his opponents. Convert the split.
Both of them.
Really nice.
Conversion.
Good stuff.
In a tight situation, 18 years old.
Well, you know what?
Okay, I'm one.
He's talking with Tour rep Tim Mack on how much he's going to move on that right lane. Connor Pickford knows how to bowl. He's made a show. He wouldn't pick a partner that he didn't feel confident in.
Seventh frame for Blanchard and Gomez. Josh up. Light in the pocket and another two.
Common theme on that right lane. for Josh Blanchard. Seems like it's either been a pocket strike or it's been a two pin. With a couple of straight 10 pins mixed in. Max score now for Blanchard Gomez, 220. Trailing by 34, eighth frame. Time is now to get back in this match, and it will start.
I don't know, do you think just
with a Gomez strike here in the eighth?
Get around or move one and a half right?
Eighth frame, ball in hand for Gomez. Toes the line here. Gave a little more room, but it didn't come all the way back.
Right.
Pin.
So now it's that same angle, but it needs to be moved just a little bit to the right. Okay. So feet and target a board or two to the right of that, or same shot, softer speed.
Running out of frames. Gomez on the single pin. Conversion for Gomez. Connor Pickford steps up in the eighth. The last time a player won a doubles title as his first PBA Tour title was Mike Fagan when he won the 2008 PBA Exempt Doubles Classic with partner Danny Wiseman. Now Pickford and Simonsen looking to add two names to that list.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Impressive. Impressive. This next shot, though, in the ninth frame could win this tournament right here, right now, for Simonsen and Pickford. What a beautiful shot this is. Right over fourth arrow. Ball falls back just a little bit in that subtle back-end reaction, and it's 10 in the pit. They are one strike away from daddy lockups.
Good feeling to feed your partner. Now 18-year-old Anthony Simonsen looking to become one of the youngest ever to win on the PBA Tour. Can help cement it. Foundation frame.
Come on.
Simonsen. Right.
He made the adjustment and made the shot. Left himself with a single pin spare attempt coming up. But a good shot. Quality move and good execution. And they're in great shape. All they need to do is fill frames. Spare here and see what Blanchard and Gomez does. There you go.
Right on it, labeled it to the back. Clean frame in the ninth for Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen.
I didn't catch it. All right, that's fine.
Simonsen is done. He performed very nicely.
Got him off to the great start.
Two strikes, two great spares, one little baby split conversion.
Must strike for Josh Blanchard in their foundation.
2-8 this time.
Going fast. God, Joshua.
That was really fast.
Go faster.
Connor Pickford, Anthony Simonsen are going to win the Mark Roth Marshall Holman doubles.
Bad shot.
Got
it. A little slap in the face.
All right.
Nothing like getting a trophy, a nice check, and a slap in the face by your ball rep.
Jimmy Callahan delivering the right hand.
Some real pressure on him.
Yeah.
Gomez finishing up.
You're good at leaving that.
His strikeout in the 10th frame and his performance in the roll-off got him to the title match. Just not going to be enough on this occasion.
Yeah, and, you know, I said it at the beginning of the match, that it would depend on whether or not that lane would hold up for him, and it did not. The youngsters pulled great, though. You can't take anything away from these two young guns.
All right, amigo. Thanks a bunch.
Have fun, man.
I wonder what Marshall and Mark Roth are thinking.
I wish I were out there taking on Simonsen and Pickford.
You know what they're thinking. They're like, eh, there's no way those guys could have beat us in our heyday.
Connor Pickford, no pressure on this shot. Connor Pickford and Anthony Simonsen are the Mark Roth, Marshall Holman PBA doubles champions, each earning their first PBA Tour titles. We'll talk to them next. Mark Roth, Marshall Holman PBA doubles championship presented by Storm is brought to you by Storm, where innovation and passion collide. Storm is the bowler's company. By Eldorado, Silver Legacy, and Circus Circus, Reno's premier downtown properties. By Geico, over 75 years of savings and service. And by Reno Tahoe USA, for your next vacation getaway, go to visitrenotahoe.com. Gorgeous Lake Tahoe. Absolutely beautiful. Four-season resort area skiing. And just beautiful. Any chance to visit. Final score, 223-173. Anthony Simonsen and Connor Pickford claim the Roth-Holman doubles championship. And Kimberly Pressler is standing by with our champions.
These young guns came out swinging, and it worked out well for them today. Now, you two have very little TV time between you. This is your second. This is your first show. How did you manage to keep the nerves at bay?
I've got to give the credit to the Storm reps. They did a great job keeping us calm the entire time, telling us to drink water and take deep breaths and really believing in your process before the shot.
Now, this is your first PBA Tour title. How does it feel?
It feels absolutely amazing. It's a dream come true. I grew up with my parents always taping the shows, and that's how I spent my evenings, you know, away from school. I was watching bowling, and to be able to live the dream out is a surreal feeling.
How does it feel to win this together?
It's pretty unbelievable considering we only met about a year and a half ago. But this kid's got unbelievable talent, and I hope that we can continue to bowl this tournament together for a long time.
Congratulations to you both on your win.
Coming up next Sunday on ESPN, it's the PBA Challenge. Next Sunday at 3 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN. In the company of two of the greatest of all time, Anthony Simonsen and Connor Pickford, cash in for their first